Well, welcome to Blasford Hill Fishery, a very cold Blasford Hill Fishery as well. The sun is literally just about to come up behind the trees. We don't have too many daylight hours. Unfortunately though, it's freezing cold today, bright sunshine, so it's going to be scratching time, I would imagine. But Blasford's got a very good reputation for throwing up some decent fish through the colder months. And this is the type of fishing, carp fishing, that I do through the winter anyway. I don't session fish. I don't really set the house up for too long. I like to come out for a short day, hit it hard, stay on the move if I have to, and hopefully nick a few rewards. But under these mitts, I've got my fingers crossed. Let's get down there, because often the first hour of light is a very good time for a bite. I'm a poet and I don't know it. That might have been one. There's a few ducks around the edges, but I do know these carp like a margin in the morning and the evening. I've already flicked two rods out. This island here is the predominant feature in the lake, and in my experience, the first couple of hours, I've been in this swim before in very similar conditions, not really seen too much, although that might have actually been a fish over there. And I've been here and just catapulted a couple of 10 millers over the top of a tiny little bag of 10 millers and a sort of 10 or a 12 mil wafter, and it's done me a few bites. So didn't really see much this morning. That, however, has given me a very big feather in my cap, because it gives me something to go on. But like I said, two rods out by the island, probably got 30 or 40 10 millers over the top. When these fish are feeding, they're actually not shy of a boilie, so it's very nice fishing, and very simple fishing as well. But this one, my left hand rod, I was thinking left or right, to be fair, I was waiting for a sign. That's as good a sign as I've seen. So I think what I'm gonna do is, where they've actually chopped the bushes and the trees down, I'm gonna be super stealthy and a little bit carpy. And I'm gonna wander a rig round there. I'll probably actually take this hook link off, have a little donk around in the edge, just try and find the bottom of the slope. On here, it tends to be nice and gravelly right the way down to the bottom, and then just sort of a little bit softer. And I wanna try and find that sort of, that crease between the two. Handful of 10 millers, simple rig, liner on my left hand rod. Fingers crossed. Right, let's get it done. Even doing much. I'm not entirely sure if it's a carp, you know. Really ain't doing much.
Oh, and it is a carp.
It's a carp. It ain't a bad one either. I think it's so bloody cold it didn't know what to do. Oh. I'm so hot. I've gone from freezing cold to literally thinking it's never going to happen, to the most jittery, like, didn't want to take it bite, to thinking it was a tench or an eel or something, to now it's a... Well, I've got to say, that ain't far off £20. And a £20 pounder on the conditions like this would be a marvellous result. And I don't even think it's midday. Bloody hell. Right, I am very keen to get this rod back out. I'm not entirely sure whether there's another fish down there to be had, but one of the reasons why we actually fished that swim is because earlier on this morning it was on the back of the wind and it was the only part of the lake that was in the sun. And if you're a cold-blooded carp, the one thing you want to do, if you are moving around, and we definitely saw fish moving this morning, is that you want to warm yourself up if you can possibly do it. So literally went and swung this rig under the rod tip just down there with a handful of 10 millers. Exactly the same rig and exactly the same method that I'm using out on the island, but in the edge. I'm fishing this rig naked, but to make sure that that sort of 2, maybe maximum 3 foot behind the lead is pinned down, I've just got a blob of putty just molded around the line. Got a tiny little sinker sort of thing just underneath there, which slides up and down. So it's really easy to move in case you have a crack off or anything. But most importantly, sometimes you just want it short, other times you want it long. So it's, it looks like they have turned up and getting liners on the island rods as well. That goes down to one of our naked towel rubbers, our leg clips with a little anti-tangle boom. I've got a flat pair, a size 6 curve with one of our little aligner liners on there and a barrel. As simple as that. Oh, and we've got supple hook link, which a lot of people turn their nose up at these days. I'm actually a really big fan of supple hook links because a lot of my fishing's done on either soft bottoms or in the margins. And I think if you've got a really nice, decent sinking supple hook link, if you're laying it in the edge or chucking it up tight to an island or in a soft bottom, it will lay over anything and it's just super supple. And in my mind, I really like the idea of having a hook link that's sort of curled up like a snake so that when the fish comes and picks your bait up, it flicks back into its mouth. I understand why people have the stiff booms, but I don't know. What works for me is what works for me. That's it, super simple. It's worked in the edge. Hopefully it works out to the island as well. We're starting to get a few liners, so hopefully this sun has warmed them up. Certainly warmed me up. I've had to take the hat off. I'm speaking really quickly as well because I want to get this rod back out, so excuse me. Right, this one's fished very close to the edge. Probably only from where the camera is, 3 foot. So I'm fishing semi-slack lines up to the island, trying to keep that last sort of rod length down so that they can mosey around and eat them 10 millers without getting disturbed. But here, everything pretty much from the rod tip to the lead, I want nice and slack because with this sun on this quiet bay, I mean, when the wind picks up, it's very cold. It's not on the water at the moment, but I can imagine them swimming around this bay, just warming themselves up. And I don't want the line to be one of the reasons why they bugger off without eating. So you can almost not fish that slack enough because when you're only a rod length from the tip and 3 foot from the bank, the bites, albeit the last one wasn't, the bites are normally pretty savage. There we go. Let's hope there just weren't that one there. There you go, what an absolute beauty. It's all about being in the right spot when you're winter carp fishing. And that's the trick. That is the key to the puzzle, trying to be in the right spot. And sometimes it takes a lot of trial and error, but like I said, the back of that bay with the sun on it, on the back of the wind, just looked absolutely prime for a carp that's cold in the winter that wants a warm up. And well, hopefully it's not the only one, but if it is, it's well worth a day out. Look at that, beautiful. Well, look at that. It might look lovely and sunny and summery, but trust me, that is a freezing cold winter 20 and I am very, very happy. Thank you very much. Oh, let's get another one. Well, looks a bit more fishy, doesn't it? But I can tell you, when that sun's gone in now, that has turned very, very cold. And it's been probably a couple of hours since I had that bite down the edge. I've had a few liners on the right-hand rod, and I feel like I probably should have had a bite off of it, if I'm honest. So after I finish talking to you, I'm going to have a rechuck. People always ask me when I should recast. And I feel like if you've set the traps perfectly and you get absolutely no indications through the day, there's probably no reason for you to... I mean, you can bait up over the top of them, but there's probably no reason for you to actually rechuck, simply because if it went out perfect, you're just trying to repeat that. And the odds are, if there's anything in the vicinity, you could probably spook them. But I think a perfect time to rechuck is if you get a few liners, a few indications, fish have definitely visited your spot and you don't get a pickup. Because for me, I feel like I had enough liners where I felt like I was going to get a bite, and where I didn't, something could possibly be wrong. So a few birds around, so they may have picked me up and just moved the rig a little bit. So I'm going to have a rechuck, simply because I feel like for the last hour and a half, that witching hour, I need in my mind everything to be perfect. And I'm not 100% sure that right hand rod is perfect. So I'm going to do that right now. Beautiful. That will go back out. Lovely. A lot of people worry about soft braided hook links, and I do understand, but the vast majority of the time I'm just putting a tiny little bag on anyway, just to counteract any chance of a tangle. As long as you hit the clip or stop it and just straighten everything out just before it goes in, it should be absolutely mustard. And when we're chucking up tight to islands like this, not super tight, but right on the edge where twigs and in heavy wind branches and stuff can fall off, at least I know that that is just sat over all of the debris nice and tight to the bottom. This sink's absolutely beautiful. So yeah, I had a few liners. I felt like this should have gone off. And as much as it came in absolutely perfectly, it's worth, just for the last couple of hours, for my peace of mind, getting it back out there nice and fresh. I'm hoping they revisit the spot. I think they will. Well, we ain't got much of light. We've probably only got an hour to go. And we've started seeing a few fish move, and one has just moved over the same spot that we saw one this morning. And that's the first time I've actually seen, so I'm looking at the bubbles right now. It's the first time I've actually seen either the same fish or two fish show on the same spot. So I don't want to take my eyes off of it. So I'm gonna flick this rod straight over the top of it. Tiny little bag, same hook baits, and see if it can do us a fish. Well, ladies and gents, it is 12 minutes past five and the gates close at 5:30, which means I've got to wind in. And when we were crunching down here through the frost this morning, if you'd have told me I'd have caught a scraper 20 common for the camera, I'd have been well happy. I genuinely would have done. But knowing that for probably 20 minutes today, I had fish feeding over my right hand rod up to the island and I couldn't convert it into a bite is a bit disappointing. But that's the great thing about short session fishing in the winter. I can go home, I can moan at the wife, tell her it's all her fault, and then in a few days' time, when the weather's a little bit better, I can come back and try and put all those wrongs right. So, but for now, we've got an uphill walk back to the van. Still got a fair bit to pack up, actually. The swim's a bit of a mess, and we've got to do it in a hurry. So, yeah, sort of thumbs up, thumbs down. It was an all right day. Very happy, actually.